I rise in strong opposition to 2046, a bill that will shut down nonprofit community bail funds throughout this Commonwealth. However, one thing I do agree with the maker of this bill on is that our pretrial holding system is in need of an extreme overhaul. Mr. Speaker, our justice system proclaims that defendants are innocent until proven guilty. Yet the inclusion of an archaic system like money bail distorts that promise beyond recognition. Instead, propping up a system that allows freedom for the haves, but incarceration for the have-nots. Mr. Speaker, community bail funds serve a critical role in balancing the scales of our justice system, allowing those unable to pay to be able to return to their families or their communities prior to their trial date. They also provide this essential service without charging the defendant a fee. There are only two countries in the entire world that use money bail, let alone allow a professional industry that profits off of people who are at their most vulnerable. Mr. Speaker, the common refrain for why we need to hold people on money bail is that it is insurance that the accused will return for their trial. But data in Philadelphia shows that 94% of people bailed out by community bail funds return for their trial date. This is in contrast to an overall failure to return rate of 70% for people who are released pre-trial. And in fact, that 94% is no better of a rate of return than jurisdictions that don't use money bail at all. However, what we have seen for jurisdictions that utilize money bail is an increase in rates of recidivism. So not only does money bail cause no significant increase in the rate of court appearances, it also criminalizes the most vulnerable of us, our poor, our working class, our black and brown and immigrant communities throughout this Commonwealth. So to conclude, Mr. Speaker, my concerns with this bill are twofold. Firstly, it would prevent community not-for-profit bail funds from conducting their essential service of protecting poor people from one of the many injustices and imbalances in our court system. These people would then be at the mercy of a bail bond industry that is less concerned about their innocence or guilt and more concerned about their ability to foot the bill. Secondly, it upholds the validity of money bail as an effective means of holding. If we were truly concerned with community safety, we would get rid of money bail altogether for a system that uses wraparound services and communications to encourage court appearance. For those reasons, I ask for a no on HB 2046. Thank you.